So hi guys, it's Michelle Labir here of Project Fmile. So today, this is our first YouTube video, so I'm pretty much psyched up for this. So today we want to talk about, or rather I want to talk about self-harm and suicide, because this is a topic that is rarely talked about, a topic that is avoided and evaded and yeah, a lot of things. So you know, we need to first of all understand what we mean by self-harm, what we mean by suicide, and all that. Now, self-harm is actually the act of cutting yourself, from what I understand, from what I know, and I am not a medic, so yet. So do not take mine as professional advice. So what I wish people understood about suicide is that first of all, it's not a selfish act. Now, from people who I've talked to, who've thought about suicide, who have attempted suicide, it's not something selfish. You're trying to run away from some pain. Now, I mean, there are other methods to run away from some pain. It's just some people view it as the only solution to a problem that they're facing, to basically the solution, which I'd like to point out is not the only solution. There are so many other solutions out there, and you're beautiful, you're amazing. If you've been thinking about suicide, I need to let you know that you are amazing, that you are beautiful, and you're worth it. I need you to just understand those two things, that you're beautiful, you're amazing, and you're worth it. So don't let people's negativity get to you. Don't let things and circumstances get to you. If you've been feeling suicidal, if you've been thinking about suicide for a really long time, then it's time you get some help. On the other hand, we have something in the self-harm. So self-harm and suicide are related in the sense that most people who self-harm tend to try and commit suicide. Now, self-harming is to many a form of relieving emotional pain. Now, you will cut yourself. For example, you are running and then you fall and then you see someone is bleeding. You understand where the pain is coming from. You understand that you're bleeding, that the pain is here. But for example, you get bullied or something, someone says something hurtful about you, or a hurtful comment about your family or something, that's emotional pain. And sometimes understanding emotional pain isn't as easy, and it's not, generally emotional pain is not easy. But like, when you lose someone you love, you feel anger, you feel a lot of emotions, and again, it is easier to understand physical pain, because I can actually point to you where it's coming from. If I'm cut myself, like this time I burned myself here, I understood where it was coming from. I understood that the pain is from here, and for me to make it stop, I must apply something here. Emotional pain, something difficult. So what most people see self-harm as a form of is transforming emotional pain to physical pain. Now, most people who self-harm are going through a lot. Either being bullied, either being cyberbullied, which is another form of bullying, or depression, or anxiety, or even bulimia, or anorexia. And generally, it's most people tend to cover up their arms with sleeves and things of the sort. But the saddest and most unfortunate bit is that how selfish, not selfish, but how we judge, how we look at this. See, I happen to be in a forum where someone actually said that self-harming is being part of a cult, that self-harming is something ugly, and that you're not able to be a model, or no one will want to marry you because of those cards. And don't just shut down, I'm not leaving the house. So I'd like to tell you that, you know, it's okay not to be okay, but it's not okay not to talk about these feelings. It's not okay not to tell somebody that you're going through something. And if you happen to know someone who is self-harming, please get them help. Please be there for them. I beg of you, like, just be there for them, because it's something emotionally hard and emotionally difficult, and it's a journey to heal. It's a journey to get there. So for more information, do read from Psych Central. And also, the one of the best mental health facilities I do know in Kenya is Oasis Specialty Hospital in Westlands, Nairobi. So yeah, this is it today from Project Fmile. Please give this video a thumbs up, subscribe, like, and share this link to your friends if you found it helpful in understanding self-harm. So thank you so much for watching. Yeah.